Let's review the equipment needed to build a budget aquaponics system. So I recently published a video to show you how to start aquaponics, but today I want to show you how to build a setup from very cheap materials. So how to find cheap equipment and being able, even if you don't have a big budget, to start aquaponics. My name is Jonathan and my aim is to help you to grow sustainable and healthy food in your own backyard thanks to aquaponics. I offer you free information and free videos, and in the description of this video just below you can get access to a free training to build your own aquaponic system. Completely free, it's a step-by-step process, you follow the process and then you are able to grow some fantastic food in your own backyard. So once you get access to the free training, you will arrive to this page. And here you will have a detail of different steps, and each time you got a video or some description to really allow you to build some strong knowledge and to know and to learn the basics of aquaponics, so to avoid any mistakes. So just enter your email address and you will receive access to this training. So let's talk about the equipment and the material needed to build an aquaponics system. So you know that there are different types of aquaponics, right? We got the growbed aquaponics, such as I have behind me. Then we got the NFT system, so nutrient film technique, where you are growing food in pipes. And finally, we got the raft system, or deep water culture, where you are growing plants on rafts on a tank. So the easiest aquaponics system to start, I believe it is a growbed aquaponics, such as I have behind me. And then you got different equipment that you can add in your system. You can add some sump tank, you can add different filters. But let's start with a very, very simple system where you got just a growbed and a fish tank. And that's the easiest one to really design. We made a video about it a few weeks ago, so you can have a look at the system, at the video, how to start aquaponics. But now what I want to show you is what type of material we need. So if we follow the growbed system, so we call it flood and drain aquaponic system. Flood and drain simply because in the growbed we're going to have a variation of water level. So if you look behind me, you got some growbeds. On the bottom you got some fish tank. In the growbed you got the water levels that is going to go up and down. This growbed is full of media, so there are some rocks. The plants are growing on the rocks, but on the rocks you got some bacteria and we want the water level to go up and down. So in terms of equipment, we're gonna need four different fins for this setup. First fin, we're gonna need two tanks. So one tank for the fish, that's what we call the fish tank, and a second tank for the plants and the bacteria. We call it the growbed. So the growbed is gonna sit on top of the fish tank. So again, if you don't know how it works, just get the free training from the description of this video. I explain you everything and I give you the correct ratio for those different tanks. Then we need a bell siphon. So that's a system that is gonna allow us to flush the water back into the from the growbed to the fish tank. So it's gonna allow us to make this flood and drain basically water variation, water level variation. And finally, we need a little water pump. So that's the four main parts of an aquaponic system. Then you can add an air pump. So depending on the population of fish you have, depending on the density of fish and the quantity of them and the species of them, you're gonna maybe have to add a bit of oxygen in your system. So basically add an air pump to increase the oxygen concentration in the fish tank. But today what I wanna talk about is a very simple aquaponics with a very low concentration of fish that are adapted to beginners, so very hardy. So generally we don't even need the air pump. It's always a plus if you can put an air pump, but if you start with a few fish, the simple flush of the water is gonna be enough. So the four main fins are really those four that we just talked about: the two tanks, the bell siphon, and finally the water pump. And obviously you need some pipes to connect the water pump to the growbed. So right now, what type of equipment material can you use for the two tanks, the fish tank and the growbed? So here you got a very wide choice of of tanks. You can buy tanks from a specialized shop. You can buy aquaponics tanks, but you can just buy fish tanks. Most of the times they are made in fiber, but they can be a bit pricey. But if you are on a budget, and that's what we are talking about today, it's really a video to help you to start if you don't have much money to put on this project, but you still want to try aquaponics. There are some options to basically find those four materials for a very low price. So first, what we're going to try to do is to recycle equipment. So a fish tank is basically just a waterproof volume. So what you need, you can work with IBCs. A lot of people are working with IBCs, and they are very cheap and they are very efficient. They are very big volume, and it works really well for aquaponics if you just want to start. So I really, really recommend to use IBCs. But if you use an IBC, so industrial bulk container, if you use those type of fins, you want to make sure that what was inside before was not a chemical. You want to make sure that it was food grade. So you know, IBCs can be used for a lot of things. They can be used to store chemical, but they can also be used to store food, you know, food liquid or colorant or whatever, but things that are food grade. So when you buy your tank, or when you get your tank, reuse your tank, find it from anywhere, just want to make sure before anything that was inside was basically food grade, or it was never in contact with any harmful chemicals. So here we are talking about IBCs, but it can be any bucket, a large bucket. It can be a bin, you know, an old bin. It can be a tub. I mean, the choices are very wide. And when you start aquaponics, if you just want to try the concept, if you want to try, if you are interested, just don't spend too much money. You can recycle fins very easily. Obviously, it's probably not going to look the best, but if you are just trying the concept, if you are just starting, if you just want to produce a bit of food in your backyard, that's completely fine. Just make sure, again, it's completely food grade. And then from there, you have your grow bed and your fish tank. So for the dimensions of those two, there is a ratio to respect. I direct you to the free training, because again, you go in the description of this video, you got all this information for free. So I'm not going to repeat in each video. It's a lot of data. So just get the free training, and you're going to have all the information you need. So collect those two tanks. So again, I think you can get them for free or for very cheap price. Then you need the bell siphon. So I made a video about bell siphon. The bell siphon, you can make them by yourself. They are a bit tricky to find the good dimensions, but again, follow the video I made, and you're going to find a lot of other videos online to know how to build your own bell siphon. But otherwise, you can just buy one that is already made, and at least you know that it works, and it's not gonna take you too much time to build it and to find the good dimensions. So basically, a bell siphon is just a few pipes, one in each other. So it's quite simple. I mean, not simple to design, because obviously you need to have the good dimensions. But what I mean is, like, there is no very costly equipment in it. It's just some pipes. So again, you can find these parts at a very low price. You can either buy it already made, or you can make your own for a very, very low budget. So those three equipments here, they are really, really easy to tick, really easy to get, and they are very affordable. The last one is a water pump. And water pump, you know, you got all prices. But again, if you follow my training, the free training is this description, you're going to find what exact water pump you need for your exact aquaponic system. Depending on the volume of the fish tanks, volume of the grow bed, we're going to be able to determine the quantity or the capacity of the water pumps that we need. And from there, we're going to be able to just find the pump at a low price, and not buying a big pump that is very, very costly at the purchase, but also very costly to run. Because you know that a big pump is going to consume a lot of power, a lot of electricity. And then, obviously, it's going to add to the costs of the setup. An aquaponic setup, if it's well designed, it consumes a very, very low quantity of power, of electricity. But if you put a very, very big water pump, then it's going to consume a lot, and most of the time it's completely useless. So just get a proper water pump that is really adapted to the size of your setup. And if you start with a setup that is 1,000 liters, which is what I recommend, if you have a 1,000 liter setup, then the price of the water pump is going to be, if you are in Australia, US, Europe, it's probably going to cost you around between $30 to $60. It's very, very affordable. If you want a really good quality pump, it can go up to $100, $150. But you can start on a very low budget. If it's just a small project, just start with a cheap pump for less than $50. And you got a setup running for less than $50, because basically that's all you need. Then you need a pipe to connect the water pump to the grow bed. So you need just 2 meters of pipe. So it's very, very cheap. Even if you buy it, it's not going to cost you much. And that's all you need, basically. Then the gravels to put the media, you know, you can basically find it for very, very affordable price. Then the water, obviously, you need some water in your system, and the fish. Again, the fish, you can go fishing and get the fish by yourself, or you can buy them when they are small and they are very, very cheap. So that's how you can have a very affordable aquaponics system. Now, I just want to add a comment to this video that is for me very important, that if you want to try the concept of aquaponics, if you are new and you say, oh, okay, I would like to see if it works or whatever. Yes, it works, but you have to start with a certain volume. I see too many people who sell very, very small setup, you know, that you can put in your kitchen. They are like 50 liters or whatever. I would really, really highly recommend to stay away from those type of setups, because they are super hard, super challenging to manage. And most of the time people buy them, they try it for a month, 2 months. After a while, they can't manage the water properly because the variation are way, way, way too high. And therefore the fish die and they put the setup away. So basically it's a lot of pollution, you kill a fish and you don't produce anything. So it's a waste of money. So please stay away from those type of pre-made setups that look good, you know, it looks like quite funny, but really honestly, it's very, very hard to manage. And try to make your own or buy one already made. But if you're on a budget, if you're on a very limited budget, I would really highly recommend to follow the advice I give you in this video right now, to get those 4 elements for a very low cost. So I think you can get it for less than $50 altogether, depending where you live. And then you start on a setup that is at least 500 liters. I mean, 300, 500 liters, but don't go below, because then you have some troubles to balance the quality of the water, basically the, you know, the ammonia, nitrate, nitrate, the thing that I talked about in my other video, in the video of how to start aquaponics. It's very, very simple things, right? But on a small setup, you can't manage it properly. It's too difficult. On a big setup, you don't have to do anything. Once you go over 500 liters, you know, it's all done by itself almost. You have to check, but you don't have to act on it. While on a small setup of 50 liters, it's going to be very, very tricky. Again, if you haven't done it yet, please get the free training. It's a lot of free information that I give you here to start aquaponics on the good basis. It's going to help you to build a really good aquaponic system and to build some good knowledge to produce some sustainable, healthy and tasty food in your own backyard. So get the free training, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If it's the case, please give it a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done it yet, and see you in the next video. Bye bye. So if you are new to this channel, please subscribe. I'm going to release one video every week.
Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!